banner. And very shortly, we're going to be bringing our dancers into the arena. Now, first of all, you're elderly, perhaps you're handicapped. Go ahead and sit back down. That's understandable. But for everybody else, we want you to remain standing with us as we pay honor and tribute to our Native nations who are gathered here for the annual 4th of July powwow. But before we do, as we always do, we'll ask individuals to render us a prayer, to say a prayer, to speak to our Creator for us. And this young man to my left right here, from the none of my tribe, Comanche Nation, from this great southwest part of Oklahoma. Mr. Manasseh comes from a long line of language speakers, our carriers of our tradition. He sits around the drum. He's a Native American church guy, very big in our traditions and our ways at home. You don't hear much from him because he's a very humble guy. He does a lot of things according to the old ways. He carries that on. His dad, that I knew very well, and all through the family in the Comanche way. He's a big language warrior, is what we would call him at home. Very proud of the fact that he maintains all of this in the Comanche way. So at this time, I'm going to ask Mr. Anthony Manasseh to give us a word of prayer.
Y'all bear along with me here this evening as I go to our Creator in a prayer. And I always say I believe in the unity and power of prayer, and that you pray along with me in your own way, your own language, the own way you pray. So I'm going to go to our Creator here as some of the relatives here asked me to stand before you and acknowledge our Creator here today. And so I'm going to do the best I can to say a prayer for all of us here. But like I said, pray along with me. Unity and the power of prayer is wonderful. It's wonderful. It's powerful. Power comes through a prayer. So maybe somewhere out there within the sound of my voice, maybe some of y'all have ailments. Some of y'all have afflicted by disease. Maybe some kind of sickness. Something has hindered you from living in a healthy lifestyle. We're here today, we speak life, health, healing, and restoration unto you here, and that you can be well, and that maybe as the evening goes on, the spirit of this drum, the spirit of these singers will move you, touch you in a mighty way, make you get up and dance, move around, and make you well. So when you leave from this great Cherokee reservation and you go back to your home, you can be a testimony to relatives, and they say, hey, I thought you wasn't feeling good. I thought you wasn't well. And you came back from over there. What took place? Well, this Cherokee reservation is powerful. There's people over there that prayed all weekend long. Even though there was competition, there was dancing, there was things that were going on that kind of way, there were still prayerful people around there. And they acknowledged our ailments, and they called upon the spirits and this drum and these singers to move and something good, to move around this arena. And that's what we did. We took step inside of this arena. We felt a good spirit. And when we stepped foot in that arena, we felt that spirit, that the good God Creator healed us from the top of our head to the soles of our feet. That's the way I want everybody to walk away from here when we depart from this great Cherokee reservation and make our way back to our destinations, our home, our homes, our respected fireplaces. So bear along with me here today. Hansumeriko Yuyamoko Nama Narami Okotama Bati Nama Ava Jesus Nansuwakaita Nama Pia Atsavi Meko Kimaka Nama Nat Nama Ai Nama Nuakaroina Taku Nami Sutai Itama Mavitsi Nama Taiwa Du Taiwa Yu Taiwa Kuexi Nama Aravitsna Meko Kimaka Ma Pia Atsavi Taku Nami Sutai Nama Ava Sokoma Miaroina God, Creator. Sutai kina ma wabi tu na tāko mari i jau ka tamawati na ma āpa gā nā sutai kina ma urako me mi a nīkui. Urako.
Mr. Manassi, thank you. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to ask that you please remain standing with us as we bring our dancers into the third session, the 4th of July powwow here in Cherokee, North Carolina. We'll start off with bringing our dancers in. We're going to start with way over on the top side, and we're going to start with the boys and just go right on down the line. It's going to be all northern this particular session, and tomorrow we'll go with the southern. The boys, gentlemen, if you would, bring our dancers in from Minneapolis, St. Paul, the Twin Cities area in Minnesota, the boys. Cherokee, North Carolina, Mr. Jack Walkinstick. Mr. Jeff Martin, post 143 colors. And I want to acknowledge Mr. David McQueen as well. That is our post 143 from right here in Cherokee, North Carolina. Eagle Feather, stand by. And all royalty behind the color guard. Again, we're going to ask them to introduce themselves here in a little while. We want to acknowledge, certainly acknowledge our tribal representation from across Indian America as they converge here to Cherokee, North Carolina. And we say thank you. We say thank you to our Golden Age category and the Indian Country Marching Band. Right here in front of the announcer stand. These are here, our Golden Age. All various categories from up the north and down the south, out west, east. Welcome, ladies. Dancers, as you pass in front of the announcer stand, make sure. Stand by. Senior Adult Category. many, many different nations are here at Syracuse's Big Event to celebrate with us the annual 4th of July powwow. All the way from Michigan, Minnesota, the Dakotas, Wyoming, Montana, Arizona, New Mexico, Kansas, Iowa, all over Oklahoma. They are all here this weekend. Texas, Louisiana. And of course, Idaho, Montana, Nevada, gentlemen, Medicine Tail, all the way from the great state of Alabama. Quartz Creek, Alabama. Thank you. live. Ladies and gentlemen, how about that? Wow. Our third session. A grand entry. Wow. Beautiful, beautiful. And some of you guys that were singing on the drum groups during the grand entry, if you are a dancer, you have a number, come up here. Make sure that we give you grand entry points for that. Ladies and gentlemen, we appreciate the fact that you are respecting our ways by still standing. And again, perhaps you're elderly, you're handicapped. We understand if you go ahead and sit down. That's okay, because we have a little bit to go yet. And this takes time, but again, it's our way. It's our custom, our tradition, and we pay honor to that. So at this time, all of our Native nations have songs composed for their particular indigenous nation. At this time, we're asking the gentleman from Michigan, guys, welcome here to Cherokee. Crazy Spirit, if you would, give us a flag song.